Good morning, Haverford. I'm Drew Fuentes.
And I'm Jack Ryle. Today is a B-Day, and this is H-Vision. Welcome back after our hiatus because of snow days and other scheduling. We have a full episode for you today.
On today's episode, we'll watch coverage from last week's language breakfast and government field trip, share commercials for the Spanish Club's fundraiser, the Drama Club's production of Shrek, and the upcoming Soul Food Night. Also stay tuned for the first episode of Touch It, this H-Vision.
And now we send it over to our weatherman, Paul Smith, for weekend weather and the Pledge of Allegiance. Please rise now for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
What's up, Haverford? Paul back in with the weather. Right now it is 31 degrees. It's going to be a high of 38 today. It's not too bad. It's actually quite nice out right now. I'm loving life. Fun fact. Did you know that birds can't pee? Thank you, Jack Duncan, for that. Deuces.
Thanks, Paul.
And now for today's announcements. A big congratulations goes out to the HiQ team yesterday, who in the championship beat Garnet Valley on home turf, beating them with a score of 56-54. Head over to the YouTube site for H-Vision to watch today's homeroom victory parade live stream coverage now.
Congratulations to Colin Pettit, who finished 18th in the state for the 200 free. The relay team, consisting of Pettit, Zach Given, David Abrams, and Jackson Graham, finished in 9th overall.
As we all know from the homeroom previews, the production of Shrek will happen this weekend. Here's a commercial from the club about the dates and times for the show.
Somebody once told me the world is gonna roll me. I ain't the sharpest tool in the shed. She was looking kind of dumb with her finger and her thumb in the shape of an L on her forehead. Well, the years start coming and they don't stop coming. Fed to the rules and I hit the ground running. Didn't make sense not to live for fun. Your brain gets smart but your head gets dumb. So much to do, so much to see. So what's wrong with taking the back streets? You'll never know if you don't go. You'll never shine if you don't glow. Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on, go play.
Next up today, we take a look at the focus of the Spanish Club's current charity fundraising efforts in the Pulsera Project. The bracelets are being sold today and Monday during all lunches in the West Commons. Students can also see any Spanish teacher to purchase a bracelet.
The Pulsera Project is a fair trade nonprofit organization that works with artisans in Nicaragua and Guatemala and provides a market for their handmade bracelets, or pulseras, in schools across the U.S. Each pulsera costs only $5 and comes tagged with the photo and the signature of the artist who made it. Money raised from your school's pulsera sale will sustain employment for nearly 200 artisans and will also fund housing, healthcare, scholarships, social enterprises, and other empowerment programs that benefit the artists and communities throughout Central America. Thank you so much for your support, and have an amazing time coloring the world with the Pulsera Project in your school.
Next up today, the African American Culture Experience Club will be hosting a Soul Food Night on this coming Thursday night. Take a look at the commercial from H-Vision editor Jack Duncan for the details.
The African American Cultural Enrichment Club here at Haverford are hosting their first annual Soul Food Night. This is to raise awareness for Black culture in Haverford. We're going to have this event on March 22nd, next Thursday, from 6:30 to 9. The event will feature Lil Zay and some really good food. So all around, it's gonna be good vibes, good music, good food, and it's just gonna be a good time. Please come and support us. It's $5 per plate, and the plates can include fried chicken, macaroni and cheese, mashed potatoes, anything that's there, you can have it. Thank you, guys.
I heard he sang. First in our feature coverage today, we have footage from last week's World Language Breakfast from correspondent Brianna Duffin.
Last Friday, March 9th, the World Language Breakfast took place in the cafeteria to celebrate Foreign Language Week. French, Latin, Italian, and Spanish students brought in foods from their chosen cultures to share with one another, each hosting two tables full.
Next up today, we have a look at an on-the-spot conversation. Do you prefer regular or chocolate milk?
So do you prefer chocolate milk or regular milk?
I am lactose intolerant, so I'm going to go with neither on that.
Okay.
Do you like chocolate milk or regular milk?
Regular milk, fat-free.
All right.
Do you prefer chocolate milk or regular milk? Awesome.
Do you like chocolate milk?
Yes.
Or regular milk?
Chocolate.
Chocolate milk? Okay.
Next up today, we recap the government class field trip through the lens of correspondent Elijah Cordray.
On Thursday, March 1st, Haverford students attended the annual Good Government Seminar hosted at Cabrini University. State Senator Dalen Leach, who runs the event, began the meeting by explaining the purpose of the seminar.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Can everyone hear me okay? Thank you so much for coming to our annual Good Government Seminar. What we try to do here is expose you to a little bit of what it's like to actually work on legislation. And hopefully from this experience you'll go forward, your whole life will be changed, hopefully for the better, and hopefully some of you will get into public service and actually do this for real, because we certainly could use the help.
After the introduction, students were separated into groups that focused on creating an argument either for or against one of three different bills. Upon returning to the amphitheater, each bill was presented and both the pro and con side argued their position. Following the arguments, the floor opened for questioning and more debate.
Another question, by the way, mackerel is excellent, like 6 months after the expiration date. is there someone who's not, yes.
After the debate period ended, each bill was voted upon by the members of the mock Senate. Each of the three bills were passed. After the trip, I spoke to H-Vision correspondent Jack Ryle, who also attended the seminar, and asked him a few questions about the event.
My favorite part of the seminar was probably working with my fellow students in the Congress sessions. I learned a little bit more about how government works. It was just kind of a really broad introduction to it, I feel like I learned more because we were actually doing it ourselves as opposed to learning about it in a textbook.
We finish off this Friday with an episode of the much-awaited Touch It from the mind of H-Vision correspondent and anchor Matt Shaw.
Touch it.
Oh my God, I can't. It smells so bad. Ew, it has to be Spam. It's slimy and really, really gross.
Is teens.
Nah, I'm not good.
Do you have any guesses before you want to take off your glasses?
Dude, I seriously gave my guess already. Tuna or cat food.
No. Tuna feels like...
Ew, is that spam?
Go down quick.
That feels so weird. Is that like broccoli?
Sure.
Really squeeze it.
I can't because I know it's gross. I know it's gross.
Touch it.
Ew!
Oh my god, that's disgusting.
I'm gonna touch it.
Touch it.
Yeah, you have to do that. Because it's spread out.
No. Ew. Mayonnaise?
No.
Ketchup?
No. I'm so scared.
Straight down.
Ew. Is this sour cream? Please tell me it's not. I have no sense. Yeah. Ranch dressing?
Yeah!
Oh my god, ew.
Just to keep your fingers together.
Okay, I'm
that's all for us today. I'm Drew Fuentes.
And I'm Jack Ryle. Come back next week to see coverage from the walkout, get ready for next Friday's WHHS Coffeehouse, and see what the best area pretzel actually is.
Have a great weekend, Fords.